Good to see everybody. We will have our invocation, which will be the Lord's Prayer, and then we will have our Pledge of Allegiance. And I'm going to ask him if he would invite back there to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. So let's stand for the Lord's Prayer, folks. Our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Commissioner Hughes.
Here.
Commissioner Moser.
Here.
Commissioner Richardson.
Here.
Commissioner West.
Here.
Commissioner Stockton.
Here. Using the minutes in your packet for April 4th at the workshop of April 25th, 2022. I hear a motion to accept the
motion.
Second. Discussion. All favor aye.
Aye.
Likewise, motion carries. The recorder has a report on distribution.
Okay, this is the month of March 2022. I'm sorry. Yes, March 2022. General fund, the first posting is the TCRS contribution, which is employee and employer contribution, $16,862.65. We also made a transfer from the general fund to our investment account in Nashville, and I just wanted to point that out, even though it's not really a bill payment. Transfer. That was $1 million after we finished collecting property taxes in February. Further down the page, fuel for the month was $10,093.72. And at the bottom of that page, $4,220.57 to Blue Cross Blue Shield of Tennessee. Page two, employee employer health insurance to Cigna, $54,128.19. And at the bottom of that page, a stormwater payment to Sweetwater Utilities Board, $9,256 for the month. Page three, we filed our 941 with the United States Treasury. And when we filed it, we put all of the funds in for one date, and they calculated penalty based off that. So we have refiled that report showing every single day's deposit, and they should refund us that. But $8,859.01 was paid to the U.S. Treasury for taxes. We think 100% of that will be refunded. And as soon as we get that, I'll let you know when that happens. Further down that page, Axon Enterprise, $21,360 for body cams for police department. That was a budgeted item. Page four, $8,227 for Monroe County Assessor property. That's the annual reappraisal fee that we contribute to the county for the cost of reappraisals throughout Sweetwater. Towards the bottom of that page, there was a property tax refund to Family Dollar Stores of $1,000. That was kind of a higher amount, so I wanted to explain that was a property tax refund when they overpaid. Pyro shows, we paid our deposit on the fireworks of $6,000. Page five, $3,300. We talked about this in the last meeting. That's where Main Street site and software was paid for from the Main Street budget. That's everything for the general fund. In State Street Aid, we had some striping to seal it ASAP, and you'll see a couple of entries to them. And then Cannon and Cannon at the top, $2,991. That was some engineering to finish up the design portion for the Hawkins and Linwood Road repavement project, which is now back to the state for final approval before they tell us that we can go out for bids. So hopefully that will happen this summer. There's not really anything significant in drug fund. In the tourism fund, Simon and Moose is who did the restoration work on the wall downtown, $2,591.82. The library report is in there if anybody has any questions about it. The home grant, we paid a utility bill from Fund 125. which totaled $240.36. We didn't have anything in the LEA fund that month. In solid waste, we paid for the garbage contract, $22,254.30. And then we had a couple entries to our public services, and that's for landfill costs and dumpster expenses. Nothing in the industrial park fund and nothing in the ECD fund, but you can see the balances in each of those two funds. Any questions?
Okay. Deal. Thank you, Jessica. I hear a motion to accept.
So moved.
Clear.
Second.
All right. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Likewise, motion does carry. We will now open a public hearing to take comments on two items. First, the Planning Commission has recommended to annex partial 11.00 of tax map 22 by the property owner's request. Is anyone present to make comments on this annexation? Annexation plan of service. We talked about this in the workshop the other night. We also have an ordinance to amend Title 10 concerning animal control. Is anyone present to make comment on the ordinance prior to final reading? Ordinance number 999 to amend Title 10. In old business, we have ordinance number 999 to amend Title 10, which we just held a public hearing on. Is there a motion to move forward?
Make a motion for acceptance of ordinance 999 as amended.
Sorry.
Motion been made. Second. Any discussion on this? Everybody clear with this?
Let me just make a comment. Yes, sir. City Judge Peter Olive was out of the country about the time to get the first reading, and he had several changes that he'd like to make. They were all grammatical type changes. They didn't really change the substance of anything. And the proposed amended ordinance that's in front of you has those changes already made.
So we're voting on as is. Roll call vote, please.
Commissioner Hughes?
Aye.
Commissioner Mosier?
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson?
Aye.
Commissioner West?
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton?
Aye.
All ayes. The motion does carry. We did receive one bid for the CDBG home grant. However, we are awaiting state approval on the bid. We will table this for the time being.
Not until we get word back from the state.
In new business, we have an appointment of an auxiliary officer to the Sweetwater Police Department, Commissioner Stockton.
I'm not going to make the motion that we want to do
it. Eli Harwood.
Yeah.
With promoting him into an off-field situation.
Second. Motion made. Second. Eli Harwood to be a dog auxiliary officer. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Likewise, motion carries. In the workshop, we reviewed an update to schedule of fees. Is there a motion to adopt?
Make a motion for adoption of schedule on fees as presented.
Third.
Any discussion?
As presented, as the proposed wording to add for the fire department call fees, will that be included here?
It is.
Okay.
So it doesn't need to be amended, correct?
Correct. It's already included in the draft that we're voting on. So the schedule of fees has to be adopted anytime we make a change to it. The primary change in this one is that the cost of gravel has gone up in the street departments, and anybody that buys that for their right of way or water runoff issues that we deliver to them, we are charging them more now. So we have to update that in our schedule of fees every year. And then they've also added call fees in the fire department, so that if you have people with professional medical people on staff, like a hospital, a nursing home, a dialysis clinic, something like that, that calls more than so many times a month, that they would pay a fee for that response. Same thing if you have a home, which we've talked to John Cleveland, we've talked to T-Mail about this for several years. If you have a home that has repeatedly maybe neglected an elderly person and they continuously fall out of bed, and we get keep getting called out to that, we can threaten that call fee. And usually the problem miraculously stops and they figure out a solution to it rather than calling the fire department out every night for 3 weeks straight. So basically it gives us a little more teeth for people that are abusers of that system.
Okay. Any more discussion? All right, let's vote. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed likewise, motion does carry. We now have ordinance number 998 to update building codes on first reading. John has provided an update draft since our last workshop and sent the packet out on Friday. John, you want to elaborate a little bit on that?
We've been working really fast on this to try to get all of the numbers and everything right in the various editions of the International Building Code that we're adopting. There was a lot of work done by Chuck and by Sam over the last 2 years, but a lot of people who are here now weren't here when that was being done. So we were finally putting it in the ordinance in the form. We were making a lot of changes on the fly. And the version that you have on your desk there in front of you right now, we believe, has all of the changes to the way that is intended by the codes enforcement officer and by Commissioner Mosher. And so we would recommend that this would be enough.
So our motion should be based on the most recent draft of ordinance number 998. Credit at your seat. You've seated. Is there a motion in a second to approve ordinance number 998?
I make a motion for approval of ordinance 998.
Is there any discussion? Roll call vote.
Commissioner Hughes?
Aye.
Commissioner Mosher?
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson?
Aye.
Commissioner West?
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton?
Aye.
We have first reading on the budget and tax levy ordinance. This draft will fund capital improvements, employee rate and benefits with no tax or fee increases, and taking no funds from our fund balance. Is there a motion and a second to approve?
I make a motion to accept.
Second. Roll call vote, please. End discussion. Roll call vote.
Commissioner Hughes?
Aye.
Commissioner Mosher?
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson?
Aye.
Commissioner West?
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton?
Aye.
Motion carries. We have the resolution to annex and provide a plan of service for Eagle Bend Development. Talked about that workshop. John brought it in. John, you want to touch base on that just before we vote?
Sure. In your packet, you should have a resolution there to annex the property to 79.25 acres off Telford Road that we talked about in the workshop. There's also attached with the resolution, there should be Exhibit A, which is the plan of services that's gone before each of the departments to meet their approval. So our utility board has also looked at and approved that. So also have a map attachment there showing it's Exhibit B. It shows the parcel in your packet that's to be annexed. So if you have any questions, I can answer.
Thank you, sir. We have a motion.
I make a motion for annexation of tax map 022, parcel 011, approximately 79.25 acres.
I'll second. More discussion? All in favor?
No.
Guess we need to have the ordinance number 1001 zoned, recently annexed partial, Monroe County tax number 022, partial 11.00 on Telford Road to R4 on first reading. Okay, let's go back up to the resolution. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, then we'll have a roll call vote on ordinance number 1001. We have a motion.
I'll make a motion for acceptance of ordinance number 1001. And it's basically rezoning of the Telford Road property that we just annexed.
Second. Motion made and seconded. Any discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Hughes?
Aye.
Commissioner Mosier?
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson?
Aye.
Commissioner West?
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton?
Aye.
Okay, motion carries. We have ordinance number 1002 to rezone Monroe County tax map 023F Group B, partial 17.00 from M1 to C3, with remainder partial in C2 on first reading. Is there a motion?
Make a motion for approval of ordinance 1002 for rezoning.
Second.
Sorry. Second. Can we get some clarification on this? Where's this property at?
This property
this is the one off Big Street, Main Street, and Big Street.
What the Dollar General?
Yeah, the Dollar General side, the proposed Dollar General side.
Mr. Mayor, before we have a vote, I need to recuse myself because I'm stopped over the Dollar General.
And just for clarification's sake, this is just a proposed ordinance to rezone. This is not saying that, you know, you're voting in Dollar General. It's just saying that you're rezoning it from M1 to C3 commercial, and technically M1 wouldn't be, nothing would be allowed there anyway because of the wetlands. No industrial would be built there because of the wetlands anyway. So you're just voting to rezone it from M1 to C3.
I still need to approve this.
Roll call.
Commissioner Hughes is recused. Commissioner Mosier?
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson?
Aye.
Commissioner West?
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton?
Aye.
Motion does carry. You got some good stock there, buddy.
That's what I like.
We have ordinance number 1003 to rezone 720 New Highway 68, Monroe County tax map 023, partial 056.05 from C3 to M1 on first reading. We talked about this as the Hall property out there. We had full discussion on this during our workshop. So is there any discussion about it before we take the roll call vote? Okay, do I hear a motion?
Make a motion to approve ordinance number 1003.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. Any discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Hughes?
Aye.
Commissioner Mosier?
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson?
Aye.
Commissioner West?
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton?
Aye.
Motion carries. We have ordinance number 1004 to rezone Monroe County tax map 022, partial 43.00 from C3 to R1 and R2 on first reading. Everybody familiar with what we're doing here? Yeah. subdivision up behind off of Monroe Street up there. I know it's a Dunlap property. We talked about it. So let's have a motion.
I make a motion to approve ordinance 004.
Second.
Any discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Hughes.
Aye.
Commissioner Mosier.
Aye.
Commissioner Richardson.
Aye.
Commissioner West.
Aye.
Commissioner Stockton.
Aye.
Motion carries. We discussed in the workshop a resolution to issue debt department for SUB, Sweetwater Utility Board, and the electrical department for a substation. Is there a motion to approve the reimbursement resolution for upcoming electrical department capital expenses?
I'll make the motion that we vote in this resolution.
Second.
Discussion. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed, likewise, motion does carry. Okay. Anything else need to be brought up?
I got some news to tell everybody. Last week, we had as many as 30 people involved in a court case from a robbery that we had several years ago from our evidence locker. And this guy that wound up being guilty for it, he ran. He had been in Costa Rica for several years. And then he screwed up some way, and the marshals wound up getting him and brought him back to Tennessee. But after 14 years, this man stole $25,000 out of our evidence locker. And after 14 years, we got a guilty plea out of the deal. And that's sort of unheard of. But this man was guilty. All of us officers, or all our department, is relieved that it's over with. Because when it happened, it put a black cloak over the department, and citizens in town got to wearing us out about it. And it took 14 years to get it solved, but it's over with now.
Did they sentence him yet?
They're going to sentence him in July. Did find him guilty, though.
Did he make restitution, or do I have to make restitution on the money?
The insurance company will probably go after him next.
Okay.
I tell you, it's what'll happen.
Okay. Very good. Understand that, but you do agree.
I'm sure all of us witnesses are glad it's over.
We've got John. He's representing the Sweetwater Utility Board here with us tonight. Do you have anything you wanted to?
No, sir. Y'all addressed all the issues. You already were comfortable with the resolution. It's best I don't say a word.
Okay. All right. One of the things I want to bring up, and we've talked about this before, I had called Jeff Barrett. He is over the new animal health shelter, and he is asking us for help on an annual basis. And Jess and I got together, we were in the budget, and we upped him $1,000. He was given him $1,500 for animal control for Sweetwater. We upped it this year $1,000, which is $2,500 that he's going to get this year. They do a tremendous service for us over there, taking care of these dogs. And I talked to Bean, I don't know, he showed up tonight for some reason, I don't know what.
Keep you straight.
Okay.
I got my kids.
I didn't know, I didn't even know he was going to be here. But I talked to Bean, asking him how much the animal shelter in Monroe County actually helped us. He said something back So I am wondering, given them 2,500 now, starting in July, what would be if we come to, could we up that a little? Does anybody have any objection to making it $4,000 instead of 2,500? They need our help, and they do a tremendous service. Pete, you got anything you want to just mention? You're our animal control person.
He told me what came
from. You
get him started, Murray, he can't get him stopped.
Well, just make it short. Do they give us a good service?
They are excellent. They're excellent with animals. We've been having a problem lately of being able to transfer over because they don't have room right now. But if we had to spend out for euthanizations and stuff, which we would probably have to do if we didn't get to pick them up our free of charge, we'd go in a big hole. Over 700 animals last year, dogs. Cats.
Well, they're going to build up. They're in the process. They've got almost $2 million in hand to build this, but they still hurt volunteers and Dave and stuff like that. John, you work close with them, don't you? You got anything you want? John Anderson.
No, you.
I thought you kind of.
Okay. What is the budget for maintenance for this department?
For animal control, not including. Well, we pay shelter to the animals, and he's got operating supplies for feed and stuff like that. It's somewhere in the $5,000 neighborhood. The budget draft that we just voted on first reading has $3,000 budgeted for them, so we had already come up a little bit from the current year. So if you wanted to do four, we could still do that without depending on the fund balance at all.
Does anybody have a problem with that?
I don't have a problem with it at all. I know there's a lot of strays that need to be taken care of and somewhere to go to have a final at home.
How do you know that?
Study in Sweetwater. Get on there.
Have you been told that there are stray animals in Sweetwater?
I think you need to do whatever you can.
In full disclosure, I'm working with them on the new shelter.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I cannot recommend, but this county would be extremely hurting without those individuals and the service that they do throughout the whole county. And the planning that these guys put into this would rival any major corporate business. I mean, they run it like CEO and CIOs and CFOs. They're very thorough in what they do. So, any money would be invested in them.
Does anybody have a problem with 4,000? You said you could have that without a budget. Does anybody have a problem with 4,000? Thank you. Don't forget the blues, bluegrass, and barbecue this Friday and Saturday. Got everybody's name, yes.
The weather will just cooperate.
What's the weather forecast, Eddie?
Sometimes.
The
only forecast for rain I saw was maybe weeks ago.
We have over 75 vendors registered, which will be the largest festival we've had except for the eclipse. We have 12 different bands playing, bluegrass bands that are regional bands. There's a free kid zone, so you can come and not pay a dime. There's no admission charge, and the kids can still jump on the inflatables. And we also have the Great American Carnival coming, and they'll be set up behind the depot, which is a huge draw, and the kids really loved last year, and it made great pictures. Lots of good food, barbecue competition. John Anderson helps head that up. We could not do this without Sweetwater Parks and Recreation helping us get set up, carrying stuff up from the basement. Sweetwater Police Department doing all the streets and securities and stuff like that. John Campbell helping me organize all this stuff with Haley and Sonia and Julie. And the street department making more vendor signs, because we have more vendors than we've ever had, and building those beautiful flowering topiaries and getting downtown gorgeous and making huge flower displays and doing crazy wild stuff when me and Sonia think of something that we need them to do. We cannot thank you enough. We could not do it without all the departments. And I'm telling you, the street department really shines during this festival because their guys can do anything. They can build anything. They can make anything. They just, every time we ask them to do something else and duck, they just rise to the occasion to do it. So.
That's J.R.
Then David and Eric and Justin, I mean, I saved you from last.
Thought you won't jump the
That's why you
Richard.
Can make me vendor signs.
Buster Richard makes sure it's done, right, Richard? It's a team effort. Let's have a good time. Okay, coming up on Wednesday, May 4th, that's after tomorrow, please come if you can make it at all, especially the commissioners and our people, to the Red Stag fulfillment. I'm not going to say it's going to be the grand opening, but it's going to be groundbreaking. You try to make it if you can. It's only going to be 45 minutes, and it starts about 12:30. It should be over. Kind of a private, if you've got an invitation to come, maybe you will be there, okay? That'll be good. Robert Hickey is here. Robert, you got anything you want to say on the rezoning out there?
I just appreciate the support of the city. We're excited about getting here and getting set up.
The reason I wanted you to say all that, Tully made it tonight for the first time. Took her
I know, like 5 months.
We're glad you're here, Tully.
Thank you, Tully, for being
here.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to invite the audience in the board. Comedy show outside on Monroe Street. Get you a good spot and watch the mayor try to help me load in the truck. Put my britches down around my
okay.
I wish you had missed that. Private while you talking there, buddy. Everybody all about it. Nothing else, we are dirt. Thank you for being here.